Hello, hello!
How you doing?
Welcome, Drew. Hello, T. Come on in.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Whoa, look at this. Whoa. Incredible. Amazing. Wow. Well, you'd have to tell me about this then. Is it Victorianized? It's been
It has been Victorianized, yeah. Undoubtedly.
It's an amazing room.
It is a good room, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, you're going to love this, Drew. These are all my relies, bless them. My dad's in the corner. His father is this chap here, Sir Peter. And look, I shot them all with arrows. Can you imagine? Most of them. I should have been given an absolute thrashing.
First impressions of Ernham Hall as you drive up, and it's so beautiful. And then we come into this Gothic Revival hallway here, which is full on. You know, it's got the gallery running around it, you've got the fantastic painted vaulted ceiling, and it is crammed full of furniture. Strangely, there isn't really anything Gothic. Tell me about this table.
Are you looking at my elephant tusk?
No, I'm looking at this. I'm looking at this.
Do you know, I know nothing about that. It's a very useful table. What can you tell me about it?
Right. It's a bit good, as we'd like to say, I suppose. Do you know anything about it?
Nope, it's been here for as long as we have.
It's a wonderful thing. Look at those feet. It's Irish. It's from about 1720 to 1740. It's been carved by somebody who's never seen a lion. So they've used, like, you know, their own face.
Ah.
I've got to ask, is it for sale?
My mother might be very disappointed.
What if you sell it?
Where's the table gone?
That is very, very nice. It's one of the nicest things I've seen in months. I suppose you look at it a bit different now.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shall we carry on?
Jamie can't sell the table, but is keen that Drew will find something he can buy, because along with the roof, he's planning to put the money towards the purchase of a feathered friend.
So I said to my mum, "Mum, what are you actually after about Drew's visit?" She said, "Well, honey, I've got the parrot cage, but there's no parrot." I said, "Well, Mum, if we sell anything today, then you can put that money towards buying yourself an African grey, because it's got to talk."
Okay, that's an unusual one.
Well, Drew, should we go and have a look up there?
Yes,
more
please.
Treasure.
I'm already sort of blown away by what I've seen. Look at this place. Oh, my God. You must have had great fun as a kid running around up here.
Imagine firing an arrow into Sir Fred. It's got to be quite a good aim. Yeah.
I think that's great fun. There's just stuff everywhere.
As ever, Drew's spotting must-have antiques. The only problem today is getting Jamie to part with them.
Again, a bit battered. That's a great thing. This is like the best country house sort of thing I like. I love it.
Having rifled through the mezzanine, Drew can't resist another look around the grand hall.
I've got to talk to you about this chair. Can you tell me
which one?
This
one.
That's a bit good. That's a bit special.
Is it?
Yeah.
What are we thinking it is?
It's a 19th century interpretation of an early 18th century chair. Can I tip it up?
Yeah.
Let's drag it out, actually. It's very light, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. There's stuff like this, right? There's furniture like this that just makes my job the best job in the world. It really does, because it's just so interesting. If you look at the work on this, look at this work. Look how fine it is. Look how nicely done all of this is. This is, it's a very beautiful armchair, and it looks, for all the world, like something you'd find in the 18th century, or even maybe a touch earlier. The original of this that I've seen were at Chatsworth, or still are at Chatsworth, and this is a copy of those. Now, if that was an 18th century, you'd be somewhere around the £20,000 mark for a chair like that. It isn't. You know, it just isn't that. But my God, does it do a good impersonation of it.
In the past, copying great pieces of furniture from grander estates like Chatsworth House was commonplace. Despite being a late 18th century copy, this chair has everything going for it. faded grandeur, great proportions, and all original. It could be worth around £7,000.
Mm. It's very desirable.
Is it worth a parrot, though?
It's worth a parrot and a half, I reckon. Even two parrots. I'd probably get... Yeah. So I would give you, for that chair... In that state...
I'm not going to take anything less than £2,000.
I'll give you £3,500 for it.
Well, that's just amazing. I was going to say, I'm not going to take anything less than £2,000.
Well, there you go.
I think it's a deal.
Deal?
Yeah.
There you go, that's a parrot and a half, done.
You can get a parrot with all the optional extras now. A top-of-the-range parrot.
A top-of-the-range parrot, yeah.
A bid of £3,500 would secure the chair. I wanted the chair, so let's make sure you give them the right price. Right, so, can we carry on?
Yeah.
Drew's hunt for items of interest continues outside in the storage barns.
Do you like climbing?
Yeah.
Excellent. Up you go.
I'll do that. This is the sort of thing, you know, you really want to try and find stuff like this. This is great. It's a restoration project, but it's great.
So, Chinese mirror by the looks of things.
Yeah, chinoiserie. 19th century chinoiserie. Wall mirror. Original mirror plate. Broken pediment, which I think is this piece here. Now you're talking. Is it available?
Yes.
Boom, straight away. Chinoiserie wall mirror. A lovely example, real flowing frame to this. Fantastic decoration. It's got a crest on it, but a cresting across the top, which is broken, but luckily the piece is still on the floor. Now, do I want to buy it? Hell yes.
Chinoiserie is derived from the French word chinois, which means Chinese, and was an extremely popular style in the 18th and 19th centuries. It was inspired by art and design from Asian countries at the time, but as very few Europeans had actually been there, it relied heavily on the designer's imagination rather than accurate representations. This gilt-decorated mirror is in need of repair, but could be worth around £2,750.
So, if I give you for the mirror £1,250,
okay,
and that's it.
Bargain.
Sold?
Yeah.
My job is finding things that are either lost or not needed, not wanted, unloved. You know, that is part of the job I do, and I have to say, I love it.
What about a screen? That must be very valuable.
It's not, unfortunately. It's a fairly cheap one. It might have a nicer interior, and it does. And then I spin round and there is a screen, and it's painted in embossed leather. It's late 19th century, early 20th century. It's a good decorative piece. Hang on a wall is what I like to do with them. Very faded. It's got a little bit of a charm to it. £250. Deal?
Yeah, let's do it.
Deal. Marvellous. Love that. Paid £250, give it a clean and a wipe. It's worth £450. £400 sold. I have a fantastic job. I get to snoop around lovely old houses, meet really interesting people, look at beautiful things and occasionally buy them. Today, Earnhem Hall has done all of that and in spade loads. It's got a lovely, lovely feel about the place. I really enjoyed myself.
Having Drew and T here, it's been an absolute hoot. We've had a really nice, relaxed time. And most importantly, we've got enough money for the parrot. The key thing now is, what are we going to call it? Well, of course, it has to be Drew.
I would have happily bought, I think, pretty much everything in the building. Really, really quite an exceptional house call, that one.
So that was a fun day out for you, not working then?
It wasn't really work. Well, my job's not really working, is it? Me, it's not really doing a very hard day's work, but finding wonderful things, and I'm extremely happy.
Yeah.